Okay, so we are back working on the cart, and today's goal slash this weekend's goal is going to be to get the fuel system plumbed and maybe take a crack at the cooling system. I laid out the shifter cables and the brake cables, and they look like they're going to work just fine. I just need to get some new hardware for the brake cables, the ends on the hub anyway. So as far as the fuel system, the fuel tank is supposed to be over here, but it's not going to be because of interference with the engine. So I'm going to see if I can make it work over here. And you can see that the fuel tank is molded specifically to accommodate the frame rail on this side. So we might have to kind of cut and make that frame rail a little bit smaller. Might have to do some stuff there, not quite sure yet. And the other thing is that the headlight harness goes through this tray down there. So, not entirely sure how this is going to work, but I'd really like to use this fuel tank if possible, just for the better kind of fit and finish of it, as well as it allowing me to run a fuel gauge and just looking and working better. So, got that. Went to Napa. Got some different fittings, stuff doing an oil change. So we're gonna try and get this thing fired up this weekend and get it plumbed in. So disregard everything I said about working on the fuel system and the radiator. Basically I got it mounted and I'm just gonna need to order a bunch of elbows because the stuff that I have is too big and the fuel tank is fighting me. So That's on the back burner now, because realistically, I can use anything for a fuel tank, and I'm not going to waste time trying to make that work for the time being. I did make this throttle bracket, which I'm actually pretty pleased with. It ties into this rear injection pump cover, comes over and grabs the injection pump lever. You can see I had to drill a second hole because the throw on the golf cart cable is not a lot, and easiest thing to do is just kind of choke up on the throttle cable. So you can see it works. Hopefully that's enough. If not, we'll have to come up with some other plan. But anyway, I'm just gonna keep chipping away at it. I think I'm gonna start prepping the components of the fuel system, like the filter, the lift pump, everything like that. Maybe we can give this thing a test fire, but I'm not sure yet. All right, end of the first day here. And not as much as I would have liked to get done, but some important stuff got done nonetheless. So we got the fuel pump and the filter mocked up. I gotta go get some fittings and stuff tomorrow. So we're gonna go tank to filter to pump. It's got this little sediment bowl strainer thing there, and then that'll feed the injection pump. I threw the step on the rear to see how much that affects the suspension, and it doesn't really that much, so it looks like the Adelief is doing its job. I'm gonna leave these in, but I think I'm also gonna try and do something to span this gap, just because I think this frame is really gonna need all the help it can get. And then I gotta order stuff for the radiator because, like I said, I didn't have the right stuff there. So I'm just gonna keep chipping away at some stuff, and we should be closer to a test run tomorrow. Okay, so today's not gonna be as productive just because we're losing half the day going to the Big E, which for those of you outside of New England is New England's attempt at a state fair. And because all of our states are so small, we have one. Anyway, so I ditched the stock fuel tank. I ordered a 4-gallon generic one, and we're just gonna make it go. So I don't know when that's gonna be here, probably end of the week, middle to the end of the week, and we can go from there. Like I said before, the fuel tank is relatively a low priority because if push comes to shove, I can just stick a supply hose into a fuel can and run it. So, got the fuel filter plumbed to the lift pump. and then just kind of ran a dummy line to the injection pump to see how that's going to go. I need to get a new sealing washer for the inlet fitting. I swapped on this side draft style intake manifold. I need to get a gasket for it. And as you can see, I mounted the air cleaner. Nice straight shot. I thought about running it up here so as to avoid getting potentially drawing water into it. And this is what I settled on. So I guess if the thing gets water in it, it's probably my fault more than its fault. Need to get a new filter for that. But yeah, we're chugging right along. So I got to order some radiator stuff. And yeah, so I guess we'll see what happens next, but we're getting there. All right, so laying out the exhaust, and looks like it's going to be pretty cut and dry. Going to run two mufflers again, just to reiterate, you know, the goal here being to quiet this thing down as much as possible. So went ahead and made a little flange there and picked up this mandrel bent 90. And so we're running a Tractor Supply muffler. I think that's an AC1. And then this is the muffler that came with the two-cylinder Yanmar, which that one's pretty quiet. So hopefully the combination of this motor and two mufflers really is going to give us best chance possible to quiet this thing down. I ordered a belt, got it in. It's too big, so I ordered a shorter one. Should be here tomorrow. So I think... and really, the only thing we're waiting for is an intake manifold gasket, which is just an O-ring. So I think what I might do is, what I should do is pull the motor out and address that. But I don't know if I'm going to do that yet, because I kind of want to wait until I get the radiator hoses figured out to see if I have room to retain this, or I might have to lop off this little guy there. So, I don't know about that. I'd really like to run this thing, but I don't want to get too far ahead of myself. So, I'm just going to keep plugging away, and we'll see you guys in the next clip. Okay, so we're going to get this thing bled here. I basically just connected the minimum of the wiring harness to get it to crank and get the lift pump to kick on. Got the fuel tank down there just feeding the system. Yeah, so we're gonna get this thing bled, and I'll be back in a second when we're gonna go to try and crank this thing. Okay, so we got fuel to the injection pump bleeder. I suppose I should probably crack the injectors, since that would be smart. Maybe we'll try it without. See what we get. I have no idea what this thing's gonna do. Cool. I'm gonna turn the fan on. All right, we're gonna try it again. Keep in mind the glow plugs aren't hooked up. It's probably why it's so smoky. Sunday night, we're still out here getting done. It's running into an issue where the clevis for the brake cable is not long enough, and it turns out that the workhorses have a different brake cable bracket that spaces it farther forward so it wouldn't reach. So fortunately, I have my parts axle from previously on this cart to use. So there is a difference in those brackets. And I wonder, it's got something to do with it being on perches as opposed to these stupid things. But anyway, just a quick how these come apart. You got your dust cap and then a castle nut and a washer and then the base of the dust cap. And then the hubs are splines, you just tap them off. And then there's 2 5/16 bolts that go through like the axle tube end. So I'm gonna pop this other one off, get them swapped over, and then we'll have brakes. And I'd like to get that and the shifter cables hooked up tonight so that all the cables are all set. And that's one more thing we can check off a list on this thing. I think we're gonna wrap this up for the night. We got the brake cables on. We got a nice positive engagement on the parking brake. And then we got the shifter cables on and adjusted pretty well. So get a nice engagement on them as well. Maybe this time we'll actually be able to have neutral in the event that we need it. So that's a couple more things that we can check off the list. And looking forward to this week. Got some traveling to do for work, but I have a bunch of parts coming in second half of the week. And once those get here, we can keep chipping away at this thing.